The Constitution of Pakistan, again, protects child as right to life, right to a dignity.
Child's age is still not determined. Somewhere it says 14, somewhere it says 16.
Koi bhi aisa program hum introduce karwane mein abhi tak nakam rahe, jo bachon ko child abuse se in general aur child sexual abuse se in particular bachane ke andar contribute kar sakta.
Jab aap bachche ko khota kehte hain, gadha kehte hain, ye cheeze phir kyunki usko apne aap pe koi aitmad nahi rehta.
Where are we lacking? Is it the police? Is it the power structure? These are the questions that need to be asked.
There are 22 million children out of school as of today in Pakistan. Kis parent ne jaake court mein case kiya hai state ke khilaaf? None as yet.
No child in the age of 16 below is allowed to work as a domestic worker.
11 children are murdered in a 2 kilometer range. Aur pata hi nahi laga community ko? Big question.
Could you just share with us your own experience, and do you think this at the state level we are protecting our children, and whatever is being done, is it enough? Would you like to share with us, please? Thank you.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, distinguished panelists, ladies and gentlemen. As a judge, I can't make a speech. I can only cite what the how the courts and the Constitution have recognized and protected, protecting the child. The issue is on child now. And to examine that point of view, how have they been recognized to under the access to justice and dispensation of justice? The first question is, a child is a word which is under the Constitution and under the law sometimes referred as juvenile, minor, ward, or a child. The first thing I examined is, while passing certain judgments, is the Constitution of the Pakistan clearly gives an inalienable right to every citizen to be treated as per law. And no action, Article 4 says, no action determined to the life, property, and reputation can be taken. The first protection is to a citizen. Article 260 of the Constitution then opens the door to a citizen. Citizen means who is a citizen of Pakistan under the Pakistan Citizenship 1951. Fortunately, a good news is child is defined under that. So the Constitution opens the door under Article 4. That is the citizen, Citizen 260, then it opens the door to a child. And then Section 11 of the Pakistan Citizenship Act clearly states that every child has a right to be registered as a citizen. So then the Constitution of Pakistan, again, protects child as right to life. Right to life means right to a healthy, and life means under Article 9, right to a dignity, which we have passed various judgments that when they file an application, a father says, he's not my child under DNA. I dismiss in a detailed judgment said, this is against a self-respect and dignity of a woman and a child. Now, after 6 years, you realize it's not my son. I will not let any DNA happen. Every person, all constitution articles in the constitutions are subject to law. But dignity is not subject to law. That's under Islam, the concept of self-respect. And you are asking a woman and a child, that's not mine. I have passed a detailed judgment on because Article 14 is a dignity. Then Article 25 and all articles of the Constitution protect that. I had to share good news today. Pakistan ratified the Child Convention of 1984, 2 years ago. The entire laws in Pakistan are now being revised and implemented and modified because the Child Convention of The Hague, 1984, was never signed by Pakistan when they ratified. Family Court Act, all laws for child protection will be dealt with. The child, when recognized by the Constitution, so one step I clarified, the Constitution recognizes it. When the Constitution recognizes a child, he is now protected all over Pakistan because Constitution is a sovereign law. And if that sovereign law protects a child, that fundamental rights are now given to the child, woman, and men, everyone. Then child can get the protection of all the rights, speech, movement, right to movement, right to association, right to this, and then I explain what, and then child will be then divided into two parts. Child for the maintenance, for the, in the issue of family, child in the issue of, as a public law. I am passing judgments where I protected child for domestic workers law. I have been passing, I have been labeled as a judicial intervention judge that I had asked the government to make a law, and then I push them to make the law, and then I look at the law, and then I pass the judgment. Subha Khan case, PLD 2019, Lahore 253. That is a case where we have brought a first time in Pakistan a law for domestic workers. And the first thing I did in that law is, no child in the age of 16 below is allowed to work as a domestic worker. Nisa baithi bhi hai, the judgment is everywhere. It's PLD 2019, Lahore 253. Usme saath ek baat ki maine, ki every child first has a right to a free education by the state. And Article 25A, when Pakistan amended the 18th constitution, we got three A's. 19A, right to expression and right to information, 10A, right to a fair trial, and 25A, state is defined under Article 8, shall provide free and compulsory education to every child on the age of 6 to 16. So the first issue is, under the public law, I've been passing judgment to look at the, under the constitution, how can I protect the child of upper class and all classes as a right to his education, his right to his movement, his right to his not be working in Bicklands, wherever any case is, I first look at the child issue first. Because one child makes the whole world. Greta, as a girl who stood out in Sweden for climate change, and she had a march of 10 girls. Today, 10 million people are following her march. One child, she's below the age of 16. My future is under stake. Child are the future of Pakistan. They are my legacy. I have to protect them. Because when I took the oath of the Constitution of Pakistan under Article 193, my oath says I will defend the Constitution, preserve the Constitution, and protect the Constitution. And I'm the guardian of the fundamental rights. And this is the issue where the child issues are dealt with. Those are normal things where courts have to look into under the family issue, because those issues are under the Convention of Child of Rights. Then, first good news is that Pakistan ratified the Child Convention. All laws, all judges are now passing judgments. Two, and it's juvenile court. We got the law of juvenile. We have established, this is Mansoori Shah, it was established the juvenile courts. Now our Chief Justice has, so child's ke liye court special ban gaya. Then there's a child court, and that child, so child will be then protected there. Apart from the other family law. Family law is something separate which I'll discuss at the end. That's, and then, also, a more important thing, first good news, convention, second good news, and the third good news, which is the most important good news, is that the Supreme Court of Pakistan has passed landmark judgments on the family issue, protecting the child, and the best judgment I have always read about was by Justice Asif Saeed Khosa, who is now currently the Chief Justice of Pakistan, where in PLD in 2015 SCMR page 731, first time I heard a very nice word, he's written that a little girl would be made a ball of ping pong and shuttle her custody during the legal battles being fought by those interested in her custody. Don't make a child a ping pong in family cases. Ping pong, they're not ping pong, the mother and father are fighting over a child. We have to protect for the welfare of minor. And Pakistan is a unique constitution. Article 189 says every judgment, if it needs the principle of law, is binding on the courts below. And Article 201 says every judgment of a high court is binding on the courts below, and I follow the judgment of the Supreme Court as a binding law. The ping-pong doctrine, I developed it then. I will not shuttle a girl or a boy between parents. I will look at the law for the welfare. Sociological part of that. In various judgments I passed, various judgments are all reported on how I've dealt with the child rights, anthropological rights, sociological rights, economical rights, psychological rights. You have to look at every part to shift a custody of a child, to give the maintenance. Then Mia Saqib Sahar and Asif Khosa, again, both Chief Justices of Pakistan, passed a very good judgment, 2015 Supreme Court, PLD 2015 Supreme Court 327. And 2010 SCMRP 431, where they have came out with the concept of maintenance. It's in Islam. In family cases, father is bound to pay, Mohammedan law. In 7, we have amended the Punjab law. Another fourth good news I want to share is, if you're standing when lawyers are arguing the case before me, my counsel, are you in Punjab or Sindh or KPK? Because Punjab Family Court Act 1964 has been amended, where in the first state of hearing, without a written statement is filed, the father is bound to pay the interim maintenance. In other provinces, it's not the first, it's not the word written. Punjab made the amendment that every child is given interim maintenance under section 17A, subsection 1, on the first date of hearing, not other provinces. We made sure that we had amended our law. So, my counsel, you are in Lahore, in Punjab, you are in KPK, you are not going to talk about it, dismiss. We have to protect a maintenance. The custody, maintenance, all parts of childs are protected. Like recently, I have given a judgment on the sexual harassment case. The law came in 2010. This is reported at PLD 2019, Lahore, page 407, Salim Sul case, where sexual harassment law came in 2010, never used, not a single judgment came because it has a lacuna of employer-employee organization relationship. I expanded with the Article 14. The woman who's working is subject to her dignity, and a woman who's working has been affected by an employer. I have to expand those words, and in that judgment, quoted Ketsenik McNaughton is a Yale professor and Michigan Anaba who brought the feminism movement on the sexual harassment. That judgment came, and we wanted to develop that. Our duty is, as a judge, to expand the law, to interpret the law, to protect your rights, because we are also a lawmaker, because our judgments are like law. Nowhere in the world, law in Pakistan is by a parliament. Manaz baithi hu banati parliament ka law Article 17 mein, aur president banata hai Article 89, governor banata hai. That's an ordinance or an act. When judges make a judgment, it's like under Article 189 is a law. Article 201 is a law. Aaj koi puche ki ji child ke rights kya hai, to conclude, but Samar ne jawab pucha, are they protected? Concluding is half a second. Yes, the constitution recognizes them. Yes, the international law is implemented in Pakistan being ratified. Yes, the Supreme Court of Pakistan has passed leading judgments, recognizes their rights. Yes, PLD 2016 Supreme Court 641, where they said Family Court Act is only for women. We want to protect them. And then the High Court judgments. In the end, I'm going to recently passing a case where in a sexual harassment case, some cases came up to me where females tried to withdraw it due to pressure. I said, no, I will not let you withdraw this case. I will not let you withdraw this. Because you will be treated, I will not let it withdraw. I've pointed certain, it's a government college case. I said, no, because I know why you're withdrawing it. You can withdraw it during inquiry, or you're drawing after the report is finalized. Since we take the lead of a Supreme Court, we lead the lead of our judges, and we are the constitution, because any case, it is one woman who stood in India, Vishakha. This Vishakha case aya tha, the 1987 SCMA page 1119, where Indian Supreme Court jumped. This, why do we do it? I say at the end, I'm labeled as a judicial intervention judge, and because when socialism collapsed in India, before capitalism coming in India, the Supreme Court of India intervened for social justice. And all child, female issues, all issues to labor and workers are close to my heart, and these are the social issues. And being a judge is my right and my duty to protect you. Thank you.
As the Honorable Judge Saab just said, that it's our duty to expand and interpret laws in your judgments when it comes to the sexual harassment and domestic workers. I think you have proved the fact that yes, this is true. And again, you said children are our legacy, we have to protect them. So from here, we move on to Ms. Mehnaz Akbar Aziz. Mehnaz, child rights convention has been ratified, but why does it seem as if it's been forgotten? And at the parliament level, I know you've been doing a lot of amazing work when it comes to the rights of children, but could you just share with us what exactly is happening and what is important?
Okay. Thank you, Samar. First of all, I'd like to acknowledge Justice Jawad here, and it's a pleasure to hear him, and it's a pleasure to have him with us and to be doing so much for children. When I first entered the parliament and I took oath, which is some 1 year ago, my first time in parliament as an elected representative, one thing I noticed was that the word children is not acknowledged, neither recognized, or neither thought important enough to be discussed. So 2 months down the line, I got the parliamentary minister to read a resolution picking up on the rights of children. And I was a little uncomfortable because child rights is not something that you know, the parliament finds extremely sexy. So when that the notification was or the ordinance was read out, I found a change hereafter. I found a change that people, especially the women and then the men also, started mentioning children and you know, the data and etc. Especially in the budget speech, I noticed the change. Meanwhile, we started to look at the laws, because we as parliamentarians are legislators and responsible for the oversight of the legislation. We are not executives. We don't carry out the orders or anything like that. So we started to look at the legislations, and I, as a first step, put in, because I've been working in the education sector, early childhood education, survival of children. So I started looking at what don't we have in Islamabad. We don't have a corporal punishment law in Islamabad. Neither do we have in Punjab. So I put that in, and a domestic workers law, which was pushed back by the Interior Ministry, saying that, ye to char diwari ke khilaaf hai, aur police wale andar ghusayenge, ya arbitration ki aap baat kar rahi hai, ye to theek nahi hai, aur ye wo karke. Both are still in the pipeline. I think it has been 8 months, but I am really pushing. I've started to look at with very eminent lawyers to clean up the domestic workers bill, which is exactly the same, a little modified, from Punjab. We picked it up from internet and submitted it, but it wasn't acceptable for the Interior Ministry of Islamabad. Corporal punishment bill to ab, you know, usko ek mahine mein wo ho jana chahiye, because we still have a lot of cases of corporal punishment. Meanwhile, what we started to do was SDGs, maybe child rights, 7 sustainable development goals have children mentioned, and we have signed it up. Pakistan has signed it up, and CRC has been ratified. But, you know, looking at the last report submitted on CRC, it is not satisfactory. Pakistan has not made. Basically, zyada shor nahi ho raha aur zyada baatcheet nahi ho rahi hai. So usme maine ye kiya ke, you know, with the support of a lot of other people, because, you know, you're not one in the parliament, you need to lobby and you need a lot of support. We created a special committee on child rights under the SDGs parliamentary task force. And the first thing that we have started to do, which has been like 2-3 months that we have created the committee, and specifically for a child rights convention, which is 30 years ho gaye, humne kiya kya? You know, taking stock. Ab Justice Jawad ko to bahut multiply karne ki zarurat hai all over Pakistan, you know, to take these things forward. We need active people who know the law. I'm not a lawyer, I'm not a specialist at that, but I'm learning, picking up, doing activism bhi kar rahe hain, advocacy bhi kar rahe hain, logon ko sikha bhi rahe hain. To usme ab hum ye kar rahe hain with the committee, and one of the key members in that entire exercise, Iftikhar sahab, is also here, is that we are reviewing all the legislations, children related, child rights legislations all across the country. So Khyber Pakhtunkhwa mein hum karke aa chuke hain. Thoda sa main batati chalun ki Khyber Pakhtunkhwa mein the question raised was that the child's age is still not determined. Somewhere it says 14, somewhere it says 16. Aur laws bhi ek dusre ko they are conflicting. You know, labor wala kehta hai ki 14 tak wo labor mein jayega, education wala kehta hai ki state is responsible till 16. Aur there are and you know when we talk about child rights, my mind used to go instantly to child protection, child sexual abuse. But then I started to study our constitution and as a legislator started looking at the situation very, very carefully and found that, you know, it's the basic right to survival. It is the basic right to development, protection, participation, education, health, immunization, hunger, malnutrition, which are grave concerns. These are all children's rights. Koi bacha khud nahi keh sakta ki mere khana theek nahi hai. Koi bacha nahi keh sakta ki mere tikke aapne theek lagwaye mujhe. Aur education mein to, you know, they are shoved aside. The newly merged districts in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, they said there are no schools. And one of the MNAs sitting there from the newly merged district said that in one school there is one teacher and 500 kids. So all of that, you know, as a legislator, as a member of the National Assembly, I think we are responsible, because we need to take responsibility of these. Also, I would like to mention Justice Jawad Saab ne mentioned here Article 25A. There are 22 million children out of school as of today in Pakistan. Kis parent ne jaake court mein case kiya hai state ke khilaaf? None as yet. I wish and I hope somebody would get up whose children are out of school and there are no schools there and have a case against the state. That is the only way the state would be. And the constitution takes responsibility of the children, and we need to, the lawyers fraternity needs to go through it through the fine tooth comb to recognize and realize ke kahan kahan cheezein hain. And like I said, from survival, from birth onwards, I would like to, laws ki or legalities ki bahut baat hogi. और अब हम जो मैंने खैबर पख्तूनख्वा का कहा कि हमने एक रिव्यू किया, लेजिस्लेटिव रिव्यू, एंड लुकिंग एट ऑल द लॉज, आई थिंक देयर आर अप्रॉक्सिमेटली 130 चिल्ड्रंस रिलेटेड लॉज दैट हैव बीन पास्ड अप टिल नाउ ऑल ओवर पाकिस्तान, नॉट जस्ट इन द सेंटर बट ऑल ओवर पाकिस्तान. मगर इसके ऊपर इनएक्शन बहुत ज़्यादा है. आई विल गिव यू एग्जाम्पल ऑफ थ्री लॉज दैट हैव इनएक्शन. बट स्टेपिंग बैक, आई वॉन्ट टू, because I worked in the development sector, I worked on children's rights before I joined the parliament. Main thoda sa aapko batana chahungi ki where we stand. First of all, population is a huge issue. Whenever we come into a forum, we think of the most ideal situation ke ji sare bachon ko ye ho jaye. I worked in early childhood education and universalization of pre-primary education. Impossible considering the rate of population growth that we have in Pakistan. It is so concerning that each one of us, regardless of what we do, should be talking about this, should be taking responsibility and thinking about it. Once we start thinking, it will start moving forward. Main thode se aapko development ke indicators batana chahti hu taki aapko andaaza ho ki bachon ke sath ho kya raha hai Pakistan mein. Birth registration rate, which makes them eligible for state protection, is lowest, 34%. Infant mortality rate is 74 per 1,000 live births. 16% of children under 5 have never been immunized against any diseases. Prevalence of stunting, wasting, underweight is high at 44%, 15% and 32% respectively. Pakistan ranks third in the world for stunting. Some 62% of children are anemic. More than half suffer from vitamin A deficiency, and 40 are deficient in both zinc and vitamin D. 5 million children are drinking water from open sources such as rivers, ponds or streams, over 12.5 million are engaged in child labor, as 24% families live below national poverty line. The cases of child abuse, which we have members who will be talking about it, so I don't want to talk about it in detail, has risen in the country from January to June in 2019, 1,304 cases. And thanks to the media, I see some media partners sitting in the back. Thanks to the media, these cases are being highlighted, but I would like and wish that other, you know, the other areas that I'm just sort of touching upon are also highlighted. We need to highlight. आजकल ज़माना ये है कि जो चीज़ मीडिया में आ जाती है उसके ऊपर बहुत जल्दी एक्शन हो जाता है. So as legislators, we will continue to legislate and oversight. अब मैं दो तीन laws आपको ज़रा पढ़के बताना चाहती हूँ, जो के उनका हाल क्या हुआ. जब law pass हो जाता है, तो उसके साथ होता क्या? Legislation legislators ने उसको pass कर दिया, मगर जब वो executive के पास जाता है, जब वो उसको उसके rules बनने होते हैं, उसको enact करना होता है, उसके लिए budget आना होता है, तो उसका क्या होता है? You know, so very very briefly, someone how much time?
बस एक मिनट.
Oh, so National Commission on Child Rights के बारे में बहुत सुन रहे हैं, 2017 से लगा हुआ है, अभी तक कोई progress नहीं है, कोई budget नहीं है, हर दफा ये कहते हैं cabinet ने approve कर दिया. There 23 months हो गए, कोई उसका membership वगैरह नहीं बनी, no representation in it from civil society etc. ICT Child Protection Act, Islamabad capital territory में advise government on policy and legislation, coordination and implementation, nothing has happened so far. Since Child Protection Authority Act 2011, अभी तक कुछ नहीं हुआ उसके ऊपर. So there are some things that ये जो है, ये इसमें बहुत गुंजाइश है कि हम इन चीजों के ऊपर फोकस करें. एंड ईच वन ऑफ अस हैव टू बी, यू नो, देर आर जस्ट अ फ्यू ऑफ अस हु आर वर्किंग ऑन चाइल्ड राइट्स, बट ऑल ऑफ अस नीड टू लाइक 5% ऑफ आवर टाइम. अगर आप किसी और चीज में भी काम कर रहे हैं, तो 5% ऑफ द टाइम हैज टू बी गिवन, बिकॉज यू नो पाकिस्तानी चिल्ड्रन डू नॉट डिजर्व the way we are you know treating them, or we are giving them the share in the pie, as and especially the earlier years when they are voiceless, their voices are not being heard. Aur aakhir mein main ye baat kehna chahungi, jab bhi hum koi discussion karte hain ya hum koi sab kuch karte hain, to hum policy makers aur legislators wagaira baith chuke hain. Ab main ek cheez shuru kar rahi hu, to talk to youth who think for themselves. That is very very important, to take them on board as stakeholders. Jab hum laws wagaira bana rahe hote hain, ki what do they think, and then you know it all boils down to the state, to our constitution, to our supreme court, and so on, ke wo in cheezon ko saath leke chale. Jaise justice Jawad ne kaha ki wo bahut si cheeze jin cheezon ka unhone zikr kiya, jin laws ka unhone zikr kiya, they are very very important in their respective domains, but we need to do a lot more. And the lawyer fraternity, we would like a lot of your support in doing that.
Thank you, Mehnaz. As you just said, ke Pakistani children do not deserve the way we are treating them, and we need to hear their voices. That's a very important point, and thank you for whatever you are doing at your own level. Aap sab ke liye ji, there's a message by the organizers. Whoever is tweeting, please don't forget to add hashtag AJCONF. Please na bhule, varna zaya ho jayega aapka tweet. Hashtag AJCONF. Thank you. Now we move on to Manizeh Bano Sahiba. Manizeh, hum logon ne abhi child sexual abuse, we haven't addressed the issue of child sexual abuse in our panel. So I would really like you to share with us some of the numbers, statistics, based on the research conducted by SAHIL. Or Kasoor ke context mein, what is the way forward?
I think first I'd really like to appreciate Justice Jawad and Manaz's presentation. So, because ye bahut zaruri hai janna ki bahut achhi baatein bhi ho rahi hain, jo Justice Jawad ne batayi, और हम खुद देखते हैं कि हमें आम तौर पे पूछा जाता है जी के आपके कानून कैसे हैं, तो हम कहते हैं बहुत अच्छे हैं और उन पे हमारे बहुत अच्छी जजमेंट्स हुई हैं सेक्सुअल अब्यूज़ के ख़ास तौर पे केसेस की मैं बात कर रही हूँ, क्योंकि साहिल कानूनी मदद देता है इसमें, मुफ्त कानूनी मदद। मानस का जो कहना है मैं समझती हूँ ये भी बहुत ज़रूरी है समझना कि जब हमारे बच्चों की डेवलपमेंट जिस तरह इन्होंने बताया कि ना स्कूल काम काज स्टंटेड ग्रोथ कॉग्निटिव डेवलपमेंट समझ की डेवलपमेंट नहीं हो रही है, वहीं से अब्यूज़ सेक्शुअल तक क्यों जाएगा, क्योंकि वहीं से मारपीट शुरू हो जाती है। जब मार पीट, जब आप बच्चे को खोता कहते हैं गधा कहते हैं, ये चीज़ें फिर क्योंकि उसको अपने आप पे कोई एतमाद नहीं रहता, ये उसको उस तरफ धकेल देती है कि जब कोई उसको बुरा भला करे तो तब भी वो मान जाता है कि हाँ मैं तो हूँ बुरा। सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू दैट। आई वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू से कि जी बिल्कुल जस्टिस, बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू बी टॉकिंग अबाउट जस्टिस डिनाइड, तो आई डू वॉन्ट टू से कि वी हैव ऑल्सो हैड फैंटेस्टिक केसेस जहाँ पे जजेस ने इतने आप कह सकते हैं हर चीज़ के खिलाफ होते हुए उन्होंने कहा है कि नहीं ये बिल्कुल गलत काम हुआ है, जिस तरह हमारे केसेस में बहुत आता है कॉम्प्रोमाइज़। और ये 11 साल की बच्ची थी, उसके मामू उसको ले गया, उसने ज्यादती की उसके साथ। और another interesting thing about that case, I was going to present it in whole, but अब मैं आपको उसकी summary बताती हूँ कि जो complainant थे वो district नाजिम of mosques थे और उन्होंने case लिया और जब ये court में गया तो एक स्टेज आया तो उन्होंने कहा कि जी माफ़ करना है, हमने तो इनको माफ़ कर देना है, माँ वगैरह होंगे जिन्होंने कहा होगा नानी एन, तो जज ने कहा नहीं, दिस इज़ अ केस ऑफ अ क्राइम अगेंस्ट सोसाइटी एंड वी विल नॉट माफ करो इट। सो दैट वाज दिस इज टू, बट नाउ लेट मी पुट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू कसूर, क्योंकि यहाँ पे हमारे बड़े कंसर्न्स हैं एज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। I'm only going to talk about January. We know about 2015 when there were 248 cases with lot of abuse. We know about Zainab's case, not hidden. A question even in Zainab's case in my mind is ke 11 children are murdered in a 2 kilometer range aur pata hi nahi laga community ko. Big question. But now let's get to Kasoor today. हमें मिल रही है रिपोर्ट कि जी 4 बच्चे जो कत्ल हुए हैं इन चूनिया। आज स्टैटिस्टिक्स अगेन इंटायरली पिक्ड अप फ्रॉम द न्यूज़पेपर्स, बिकॉज वी डू दैट, आवर क्रूअल नंबर पब्लिकेशन इज रिकग्नाइज्ड फॉर डेटा विच इज़ देन वेरीफाइड, बिकॉज वी ऑल्सो कॉल इन टू द पुलिस स्टेशन, बिकॉज वी ऑफर फ्री लीगल एड। Today's data for 6 months shows that there have been 40 cases of sexual abuse in Kasoor, out of which 13 have been in the tehsil, Kasoor tehsil, 11 have been in Chunia tehsil, 11, not 4. 5 have been in Patoki tehsil and 1 in Krishna tehsil. कृष्णा क्या कहें कोर्ट राधन कृष्णा जी जी 40 केसेस हैव बीन रिपोर्टेड, वेयर आर दे, व्हाट हैज बीन डन, व्हाट एक्शन हैज बीन टेकन, हु हैज एक्चुअली इवन बॉदर्ड टू टॉक अबाउट दोज चिल्ड्रन। This is only cases. Otherwise, if we add there have been abduction and missing, which is also means sexual abuse, but we are looking at those which are exact sexual abuse cases. So, in my opinion, I am asking: is this a network? And why is this not being investigated? How can it be that children And if you look at Kasoor district, we've mapped it. I had a presentation, so I could have shown you. You can see that it is entire Kasoor district that is covered with the sexual abuse cases. So that's where we are really stuck. Where are we lacking in the ability to deal with this? Is it police? Is it power structures? Is it mafias we can't find? Which I don't think can be possible. You can find if you want to find.
Even after knowing about these 40 cases, where are we lacking? Is it the police? Is it the power structure? These are the questions that need to be asked. Thank you so much. Mona, aapse aur Iftikhar, aapse. Main briefly chahungi, of course, aapka time hum zarur denge, lekin access to justice, how important is that? Aur bachon ka child friendly ek pura system hona, how important is that to address these issues? Jeez.
Bachche tabhi apne gharon mein mehfooz mehsoos kar sakte hain apne aap ko jab unko ek unki rights protected hon aur unko ye knowledge ho aur unko ye lage ke wo aisa kar sakte hain. Ab ye jo issue hai basically, जो acts उनके उनको empower करना के they can access justice easily in their country or within their community or क्या तरीके का आ रहे हैं. These are this is the point that I am going to try and highlight today. Pakistan, I'm not going to go. I was going to give you a bit of a background international. Law ke perspective se aur kyun as a result Pakistani state jo hai us has to guarantee Pakistani children their rights lekin we'll move on to access to justice. Access to justice jo hai is a human right and it is also what makes other rights for children a reality. For children's rights to be more than a promise, there must be a way for those rights to be enforced. SDG, ab hum sustainable development goals ki baat karte hain. Pakistan is bound to implement the SDGs in its legislation on a national level. SDG 16 jo hai wo focus karti hai on access to justice, and it's not just access to justice for the general population but also for children. So access to justice ki importance abhi recently highlight hui hai. Ek report nikli hai which is called A Tool for Justice, the Cost Benefit Analysis of Legal Aid, which is a joint report that has come out by that has been written by the International Bar Association and the World Bank, and it has just been launched earlier this month in Seoul in South Korea. And that report has underscored that increasing access to justice can be a win-win for businesses. Improving legal aid services is as crucial as provision of hospitals, schools and roads by governments. Failing to do so shifts the financial burden to other areas of government spending such as healthcare, housing, prisons and child protection. The International Bar Association claims that 5.1 billion people across the world lack meaningful access to justice, and such unaddressed legal needs affect the individuals, families, justice system, systems, economy and society overall by perpetuating vicious cycles of poverty, inequality and marginalization. The World Bank also claims that strengthening legal aid increases access to justice and ensures rule of law is upheld. It saves government money and therefore strengthens the economy in the long run. So this is probably something that Mehnaz can highlight in the parliament. This report studied 50 legal aid programs across the world. There was also a survey. So what I'm trying to highlight is a number of studies which have already highlighted how important access to justice is, because if people don't feel they can access justice, then the next stages, which is the having a good legal framework, all of that doesn't come into the picture. So there was a survey done by the International Bar Association and the Bingham Center for the Rule of Law, and the report was launched in October 2016. Now, that report was the result of a survey that they conducted where In that survey, respondents, which included the judiciary across various jurisdictions, lawyers, child protection officers, police, various sort of stakeholders involved in these in the implementation of children's rights, and most survey respondents felt that poor access to legal aid and assistance, lack of available and effective complaints mechanisms, and poverty are the main barriers that are least likely to change in the next decade or so. And these are the main barriers to access to justice. You can think about the situation in Pakistan and how that correlates with that. Any remedy or any solution that is that can be thought of has to be able to empower children. So this is the basis or the bottom line that needs to be kept in mind by stakeholders, policymakers. Okay, how do we empower the child, any person living within any jurisdiction below the age of 18, or as their jurisdiction defines an adult, needs to be able to feel empowered. And the unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, most serious barriers to children's access to justice lie in the practicalities. So you see, you've heard about some good cases. You've also heard about some good legal frameworks and legislative efforts being made. But if we could just focus a little bit on the basic practicalities, that might also help. So I'm just going to suggest some practical steps for the rest of the panel and for the audience. And these are, for example, waiving court fees for children's cases. Any petitioner below the age of 18 trying to come to the court, maybe that is something that can be considered. Limiting formal restrictions involving children, formal legal restrictions. The children being given the right to have a lawyer of their own choosing when receiving legal aid, for example. Active legal and bar associations, proactive legal and bar associations offering pro bono assistance. So that is, again, this I'll come back to the pro bono bit shortly. Limitation periods not starting until the child turns 18. The opportunity to give evidence not under oath where not understood, for example, and children of any age should be empowered enough to give evidence or testimony in court should they feel that they are able to do so. Children should have the right to appeal judgments. Privacy of children in legal proceedings should be guaranteed by the law, and cases involving children should be resolved without delay. Child-friendly evidence procedures should be put in place. Now, another thing that the states, that countries can do is to make collect data and analyze it and make it easily accessible for policymakers and parliamentarians to be able to affect these recommendations.
Excellent, especially the recommendations, the practical steps. I think that's something that is very much needed. And the importance of empowering children, I think that's a very important point. Finally, Ji, and then we would love to take a few questions. Iftikhar Saab, we've been talking about, you know, all these legal issues and recommendations and everything. How important is the prevention part? कि बच्चों की जब हम प्रोटेक्शन की बात करते हैं प्रिवेंशन पे कितना काम जरूरी है एज अ चाइल्ड राइट्स एक्टिविस्ट आप अगर हमें बताएं
इससे पहले बात हो चुकी कि दिस इज द 30th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ यूएन कन्वेंशन ऑन द राइट्स ऑफ द चाइल्ड सो गाइडलाइंस आए हुए बच्चों के लिए हमने क्या करना है 30 साल पहले हमें बता दिया गया था सो इसके ऊपर तो कोई कंफ्यूजन नहीं है कि करना क्या है हम नहीं कर रहे तो दैट्स फॉल्ट एट आवर पार्ट लेकिन हमें पता है यानी आई मीन रिटर्न में सब चीज़ें मौजूद हैं कि हमें क्या करना है बच्चों के राइट्स कौन कौन से हैं विच आर रिकग्नाइज्ड और पाकिस्तान वॉज अमंग वेरी फर्स्ट 20 कंट्रीज जिन्होंने सबसे पहले इस कन्वेंशन की रेटिफिकेशन की थी और अगले साल हमारे 30 साल जो है वो मुकम्मल हो जाएंगे आर्टिकल 19 ऑफ यूएन कन्वेंशन ऑन द राइट्स ऑफ द चाइल्ड क्लियरली आस्किंग स्टेट पार्टीज दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड कि कन्वेंशन के पार्टी जो है वो स्टेट है, मैं या आप उसकी पार्टी नहीं है। हम जो काम कर रहे हैं दैट इज एडिशनल इन सपोर्ट, बट एक्चुअली कन्वेंशन की जो इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी है, पार्टी है, दैट इज स्टेट, वो ये रियासत है। इस कन्वेंशन की इफेक्टिव इंप्लीमेंटेशन के लिए कन्वेंशन ये कहता है कि हुकूमत किस तरह से क्या क्या इकदाम करेगी। लेजिस्लेटिव इज द वन एस्पेक्ट, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव अरेंजमेंट्स करेगी, रिसोर्स एलोकेशन करेगी, द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एरिया। कोई भी लॉ आप उठा के देख लें, दुनिया के बेहतरीन ड्राफ्टर से बुलवा के वो पाकिस्तान में आप उनसे लॉ ड्राफ्ट करवा लें, लेकिन जब तक उस लॉ की एग्जीक्यूशन के लिए ना आप बंदे देंगे ह्यूमन रिसोर्स, ना आप पैसे देंगे फाइनेंशियल रिसोर्स, तो यकीन रखें कि आपने कुछ नहीं किया। आप दिल को तसल्ली जरूर दे लेंगे जी हमने एक लॉ बना लिया, बट दैट्स नॉट गोइंग इनटू इंप्लीमेंटेशन विदाउट द प्रोविजन ऑफ एडिक्वेट फाइनेंशियल एंड ह्यूमन रिसोर्स। सो इंपॉर्टेंट एरिया ऑफ जिसको हम खास तौर पर चाइल्ड सेक्सुअल अब्यूज और चाइल्ड अब्यूज के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में, विच इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट इज प्रिवेंशन। बहुत मशहूर मुहावरा है, प्रिवेंशन इज बेटर देन क्योर, परहेज इलाज से बेहतर है। आप ऐसी नोयत में जाएं ही क्यों जहां पर हम अपने बच्चों को खतरात में डालें। लेकिन तारीख बताती है, बहुत सौ साल पुरानी नहीं, मैं बिल्कुल भी, मैं कभी हिस्ट्री का तालिबे इल्म नहीं रहा, सिर्फ चंद साल पहले 2015 हुसैन खान वाला चाइल्ड सेक्सुअल एक्सप्लाइटेशन वीडियो पोर्नोग्राफी बहुत बड़ा स्कैंडल, 2017 जैनब और उस जैसी बाकी कई बच्चियों का सेक्सुअल अब्यूज एंड मर्डर आफ्टर सेक्सुअल अब्यूज बहुत बड़ा स्कैंडल, रिसेंटली चूनिया चार बच्चों का मर्डर आफ्टर सेक्सुअल अब्यूज इज अ बिग स्कैंडल एंड चैलेंज। व्हाट हैपेंड, क्या हुआ उसके बाद, कौन सी ऐसी पेशबंदी की, कौन से ऐसे इकदाम किए गए? मुझसे आप पूछेंगे मेरा जवाब होगा 0+0=0। कोई भी ऐसा प्रोग्राम हम इंट्रोड्यूस करवाने में अभी तक नाकाम रहे जो बच्चों को चाइल्ड अब्यूज से इन जनरल और चाइल्ड सेक्सुअल अब्यूज से इन पर्टिकुलर बचाने के अंदर कंट्रीब्यूट कर सकता। हमने कमिटमेंट किया कि हम निसाब के अंदर रिफॉर्म्स लेकर आएंगे, हम नहीं ला सके। हमने 7 फरवरी 2018 को चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन डे सेलिब्रेट किया, जब मैं हम की बात करूं तो इट्स मीन द गवर्नमेंट, सो बिकॉज आई वॉज द पार्ट ऑफ दैट ऑल प्रोसीडिंग। सो 7 फरवरी को जब चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन डे सेलिब्रेट किया गया तो एक किताबचा इंट्रोड्यूस करवाया गया, महफूज बच्चे मजबूत पाकिस्तान, किसी स्कूल तक वो नहीं पहुंच सका। टीचर्स के लिए कहा यह गया और हमेशा हमने ये कहा कि टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग इज वेरी मच इज एसेंशियल, और ये आप अपने रिसोर्सेज में रह के कर सकते हैं। यू हैव अ फुल फ्लेज टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट, डायरेक्टोरेट ऑफ स्टाफ डेवलपमेंट, और अब उसका नाम है कायदे आजम अकेडमी फॉर एजुकेशनल डेवलपमेंट। आपको जस्ट अपने मास्टर ट्रेनर्स की कैपेसिटी बिल्ड करनी है और साल में 10,000 से ज्यादा टीचर्स की कैपेसिटी को आप बेहतर कर सकते हैं। आपके पुलिस ट्रेनिंग इंस्टीट्यूट, मुझे बताइए कितने ऐसे, आप सब लोग चूंकि वकला की बहुत बड़ी यहां पर तादाद मौजूद है, बताएं तो सही कि थानों में तफ्तीश के औकात कार क्या होते हैं, शाम के, मगरिब के, असर के बाद के। सो फॉर अ 12-year-old गर्ल, 10 साल के बच्चे के लिए वुड इट बी कन्वीनियंट टू बी इन द पुलिस स्टेशन प्रेमिसेस, जहां पर जो प्राइवेसी के स्टैंडर्ड्स होंगे वो मुझसे बेहतर आप जानते हैं, आप रोजाना की बुनियाद पर इन केसेस को हैंडल करते हैं। इसी कुर्सी पे मुलजम बैठा है, इसी कुर्सी के ऊपर विक्टिम बैठा है, और बाज़ दफा विक्टिम नीचे बैठा होता है कुर्सी के और वो तफ्तीश हो रही होती है। सो वी नीड टू इंट्रोड्यूस अ रोबस्ट इन्वेस्टिगेशन सिस्टम, चाइल्ड फ्रेंडली इन्वेस्टिगेशन सिस्टम, और हम हमेशा से ये तजवीज़ देते रहे हैं कि बहुत अच्छी बात हो कि अगर खवातीन पुलिस इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑफिसर्स को आप ये काम जो है वो दें। सो जहाँ जहाँ पर जो जो चीज़ें होने वाली थी वो नहीं हो सकी। मैं एक अच्छी एग्जाम्पल आपको सुनाता हूँ, और ये अच्छी का वर्ड जो विच विल बी रिफ्लेक्टिंग द प्रायोरिटीज ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन एंड वेलफेयर ब्यूरो विच इज़ अ रिनाउंड इंस्टीट्यूशन, बहुत सारे हमारे जजेस भी, हमारे वकला भी, हमारे हाई लेवल के पॉलिटिशियंस भी वहाँ पर विजिट करते हैं और बड़ा खुश होते हैं, उसको विजिट करके दुआएं देते हैं। बट द गवर्नेंस सिस्टम, आखिरी मीटिंग बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर की चौधरी परवेज अलाई साहब ने बतौर वजीर अला पंजाब चेयर की हुई है। सो यू कैन इमेजिन कि 10-11 साल के अंदर चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन वेलफेयर ब्यूरो के बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर की एक भी मीटिंग नहीं हुई, विच वॉज द फॉरम के जहां पर हमने इस तरह के चीज़ों को डिस्कस करना था, इनिशिएट करना था और उसको इंप्लीमेंटेशन में लेके जाना था। सो मुझे ये लगता है कि बच्चों के को अब्यूज से बचाने के लिए एक कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव एक्शन प्लान को डेवलप करने की ज़रूरत है। वो एक्शन प्लान जो प्रिवेंशन को कवर करे, वो एक्शन प्लान जो रिहैबिलिटेशन की बात करे, वो एक्शन प्लान जो बच्चों की अब्यूज, बच्चों की और इन फैमिलीज की एक्सेस टू जस्टिस को इंश्योर करने के अंदर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट करे। कैसे आएगा, कौन लेके आएगा, इसके ऊपर सीरियस क्वेश्चन है जिसके लिए एक और नशिस्त की ज़रूरत है। बिकॉज बच्चे हैं किसके, मैंडेट किसके हैं, यहाँ पर अगर जो लोग गवर्नमेंट के सिस्टम को समझने वाले बैठे होंगे तो बखूबी समझ सकेंगे कि सरकार का हर डिपार्टमेंट अंडर सर्टन रूल्स ऑफ बिजनेस काम करता है और बच्चे किसी डिपार्टमेंट के रूल्स ऑफ बिजनेस में नहीं है। आप सोशल वेलफेयर का मैंडेट उठा के देख लें, सो दैट्स टॉकिंग अबाउट सोशल प्रोटेक्शन, नॉट द चिल्ड्रन। और मजे की बात, दुनिया भर के अंदर जो बच्चों की प्रोटेक्शन के इंस्टीट्यूट है उनको सोशल इंस्टीट्यूशंस के अंदर रखा जाता है। हमारे यहाँ एक नई रफ्ज़ चल पड़ी है कि इनको सिक्योरिटी एजेंसीज के या सिक्योरिटी डिपार्टमेंट्स के, मसलन होम डिपार्टमेंट पंजाब इज द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन एंड वेलफेयर ब्यूरो। सो एक बड़ा ह्यूज डिस्कनेक्ट है. हमारे पास ट्रेंड ह्यूमन रिसोर्स नहीं है जो इन बच्चों के साथ इंटरेक्ट करेगा, जो कम्युनिटी लेवल पर जाकर जो है वो इन बच्चों को इंगेज करे, कम्युनिटीज को इंगेज करे, लोकल सतह के ऊपर जो है वो अवेयरनेस रेजिंग को प्रमोट किया जाए. सो दैट रिक्वायर्स अ होलिस्टिक प्रोग्रामिंग. ये डंग द पाउ स्ट्रेटजी से अब काम नहीं चलेगा. एक आध वर्कशॉप, एक दो सेशन, एक दो डिस्कशंस लोगों के साथ, पब्लिक के साथ विल नॉट बी गोइंग टू मेक एनी बिग डिफरेंस. वी रिक्वायर्स अ सीरियस एक्शन प्लान. कंटिन्यूटी चाहिए, कंसिस्टेंसी चाहिए, फॉलोड बाय एडिक्वेट फाइनेंशियल एंड ह्यूमन रिसोर्स. और जब तक हम इन तमाम रिसोर्सेज की प्रोविजंस को इंश्योर नहीं करेंगे, खुश हो जाए हम कह के कि हम सबकी जिम्मेदारी है, बट मुझे लगता है कि वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू मेक एनी डिफरेंस जब तक हम इस मामले में संजीदगी का मुजाहरा नहीं करेंगे.
मेरे ख्याल से ये जो फाइनल आपके ये पूरे वर्ड्स थे कि बच्चे एक प्रायोरिटी नहीं है जब हम एक्शन की बात करते हैं, एंड वी नीड अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव holistic approach yes. when it comes to addressing yes. this very important issue.
Just out of interest, what sort of provisions are available in Pakistan, and what sort of work is being done towards perhaps legislating specifically on sexual offences, especially in light of the cases that you've referred
okay.
to?
Thank you, G.
We have passed various judgments when there is no law, when there is no policy, court intervenes. If there is a case passed, Suba Khan case came, and court intervened. Mm-hmm. And Samar brought a case in Supreme Court also on Vana. She's an activist. She brought a case in Supreme Court for a Vana wale issue pe.
So
Varasana Vani pe. So issue is that there is the courts have the jurisdiction to direct the government to have a policy, because every government department mandate is to form a law and the policy. And if there's no department, court can direct them to make a policy. To I always come up with good news. I can see today the issue which Samar is heading is a child, right? There's a child sitting in front of me. Mm-hmm. She's waiting justice. Aap khade ho baare, aage ja rahe hain. A child, I can show you, a child wearing a father's coat as a justice. And she's protected by a justice. This is a very example. Aapko aur kya chahiye? Aapka naam kya bete? Minal is wearing a coat and she's saying, I'm seeking the protection of a coat and I'm seeking a protection of a justice. And I'm acknowledging it. Thank you.
Integrated और realistic approach चाहिए बच्चों को सेफ गार्ड करने के लिए. लेकिन इशू ये आ रहा है कि फेडरल गवर्नमेंट लेवल के ऊपर और प्रोविंशियल की प्रोविंसेस की कोऑर्डिनेशन में कोई एक फोरम नहीं है. मुख्तलिफ फोरम्स मुख्तलिफ प्रोविंसेस में काम कर रहे हैं. मुख्तलिफ मैं आपको 15 महकमों के नाम गिनवा सकता हूँ जो चाइल्ड के ऊपर काम कर रहे हैं, उनके प्रोटेक्शन के ऊपर, उनके दीगर अफेयर्स के ऊपर काम कर रहे हैं. इनकी आपस की कोऑर्डिनेशन कोई नहीं है. इनके ऊपर कोई चेक एंड बैलेंस करने वाला कोई ऊपर का इदारा कोई नहीं है. और जो सिविल सोसाइटी है वो भी फेल हो चुकी है गवर्नमेंट को रियलाइज़ करवाने में. कोई ऐसा कोई इदारा होना चाहिए जो इन तमाम को सुपरवाइज भी कर सके, कोऑर्डिनेट भी कर सके और इनकी एक्टिविटीज़ को फ्रूटफुल भी साबित कर सके. जब तक ये काम नहीं होगा ये तमाम एक्टिविटीज फेल हो जाएंगी. आई थिंक मैं इसके ऊपर कि इसके ऊपर कैसे जाया जा सकता है, गवर्नमेंट को कैसे कन्विंस किया जा सकता है.
स्पेशल कमेटी बनाई चाइल्ड राइट्स की इन द पार्लियामेंट और वो इसी वजह से बनाई टू एंड वी आर कैरिंग आउट द रिव्यू इन ऑल द प्रोविंसेस. और उसमें इट्स अ मल्टी स्टेक होल्डर रिव्यू ना, ताकि एवरीबडी कम्स टुगेदर एंड वी स्टार्ट गेटिंग प्रपोजल्स कि किस तरीके से इसको जॉइंट एक मूवमेंट. 18वीं तरमीम के बाद फेडरल जो है वो प्रोविंसेस को डिक्टेट नहीं कर सकता, बट वी कैन कम टुगेदर जॉइंटली टू वर्क टुगेदर. मैं आपको आपका बिल्कुल जो फ्रस्ट्रेशन है वो समझ सकती हूँ कि जी कोई अम्ब्रेला नहीं है. दिस इज़ एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आई फील कि कोई अम्ब्रेला नहीं है. अब हमने एक कमेटी, जो गुड न्यूज़ है, जैसे जस्टिस जावाद ने बहुत सी गुड न्यूज़ बताई, जो गुड न्यूज़ है वो ये है दैट यू नो वी हैव फॉर्म्ड दिस स्पेशल कमेटी एंड दिस हैज़ बीन साइंड ऑफ बाय द स्पीकर ऑफ द नेशनल असेंबली. इट्स अ टोटल बाईपार्टिज़न एफर्ट और उसमें यह है कि वी विल ट्राई टू ब्रिंग पीपल टुगेदर टू वर्क. एंड इट्स नॉट जस्ट पार्लियामेंटेरियंस, इट्स ऑल द पीपल हु आर इंटरेस्टेड टू डू सम सीरियस बिजनेस.
मेहनाज से मेरा सवाल है. माई नेम इज़ अरसलान रशीद, आई एम पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी, फ्रॉम पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी. मेरा सवाल यह, बहुत ज़्यादा सक्सेस स्टोरीज़ आपने शेयर की हैं चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन के हवाले से. अब मुझे ये बताएं कि 30 साल में आप हुकूमत में रहे हैं, आपने बच्चों की ज़िंदगी के लिए, चाइल्ड प्रोटेक्शन बाद में आता है, राइट टू लिव के लिए बच्चों के लिए क्या किया आपने? एंड सेकेंड वन इज़ मैम, आपसे सवाल है मेरा, मैम मुनीजा से, कि आपने ये कहा कि हमने बहुत ज़्यादा सिक्योरिटी एजेंसीज़ को हम फोर्स करते हैं, अब उन्हें फोर्स क्यों करते हैं? अब बच्चों को क्यों नहीं बताते हैं कि गुड टच और बैड टच है क्या? आप सोसाइटी, मैं उनके साथ काम कर रहा हूँ, कैन यू प्लीज़ एक एग्जाम्पल, جب میں گڈ ٹچ اور بیڈ ٹچ اور ایس آر ایچ آر کے بارے میں بتا رہا تھا بچوں کو, اور ایک بچی کے پاس جا کے میں بالکل کھڑا ہو گیا اور وہ ڈر گئی کہ سر مجھے نہیں پتا کہ آپ کھڑے ہیں, اور میں اتنا ڈر گئی ہوں کہ ابھی آپ سے میرا 12 دن کا اٹریکشن ہے اور میں سوسائٹی میں جا کے کس طرح سے موو کروں گی.
میں جی اس سے پہلے کہ یہ جواب دیں, میں بھی اس ایریا میں کام کرتی ہوں. یہ ایک بہت کامن سوال ہوتا ہے کہ آپ لوگ اتنے سالوں سے یہ کر رہے ہیں, آپ اتنے, میرا ہمیشہ یہ سوال ہوتا ہے, بچے تو ہم سب کے ہیں نا, اور جب ہم ہولسٹک اپروچ کی کرتے ہیں تو آپ نے جو ابھی بچی سے یہ بات کی, آپ کو یہ کرتے رہنا ہوگا. ہر انڈیویجول کا اپنا رول ہوتا ہے.
یو نو کلیکٹیولی ایز اے نیشن اپ ٹل ناؤ وی ہیو فیلڈ, بٹ آئی تھنک کہ اب سچویشن اتنی ڈسمل ہو چکی ہے کہ آئی ایم سینگ اے اسپارک. I'm really seeing a spark in you, in others, in this little, this young woman, young girl sitting here, and her sister sitting here, jo ke baithe mein aur sun rahi hai sari cheeze na. So I'm, and all the young people and lawyers, and all of us who are coming together because we are saying that up till now what has happened is not acceptable. میں آپ کو بتاؤں کہ پارلیمنٹ میں یہ اسپیشل کمیٹی بنانا کوئی آسان کام تھا؟ یہاں میرے کولیگ حسن حکیم بیٹھے ہوئے ہیں, انہوں نے کس طریقے سے اس نوٹیفیکیشن کو آگے کیا؟ کوئی بچوں کی بات سننے کو تیار ہی نہیں ہے. مطلب یہ ہے کہ یہاں پر چل رہے ہو لیجسلیٹیو ریویو کرنا, کتنے ٹیکنیکل لوگ بٹھائیں جس میں افتخار صاحب بھی ہیں, مطلب کوئی آسان کام تو نہیں ہے. اور یہ سب سے بوسیدہ کام ہے, آپ کا میڈیا نہیں کور کرتا. آج کو میں کہوں کہ جی میں نے ٹاک شو کرنا ہے چائلڈ رائٹس کے اوپر, تو وہ کہیں گے بی بی گھر بیٹھے ہیں, اپنے ہسبینڈ کو بھیجیں جو 2-3 باتیں سنائیں کسی کو. یو نو سو دس از دا تھنگ کہ وی ہیو کلیکٹیولی فیلڈ. بیٹا آپ ہیں لیڈرز, آپ ہمیں بھی سہارا دیں, ہم جو کام کر رہے ہیں اس میں ہمارے ساتھ کھڑے ہوں.
ایوری ون ہیز ٹو کنٹریبیوٹ, ایوری ون ہیز ٹو ٹاک اباؤٹ اٹ, اور ہم جتنا کر سکتے ہیں ہم کر رہے ہیں, بٹ دیٹس ناٹ انف, ناٹ انف ایٹ آل.
ان دی لاسٹ 3 مانتھس آئی ہیو بین ایبل ٹو گیٹ 4 چلڈرن پاکستانی نیشنلز بیک انٹو دی کنٹری, ہو ور ابڈکٹڈ انٹو دی یونائیٹڈ کنگڈم, اینڈ الحمد للہ آئی ہیو گاٹ 3 چلڈرن ہو ور ابڈکٹڈ فرام دی یونائیٹڈ کنگڈم اسسٹنگ جسٹس فرانسس آف دی رائل کورٹ آف جسٹس back into the United Kingdom.
Excellent.
I just feel that the law, all we have is a UK Pakistan protocol 2003, and this is what we use in the High Court. There is no proper law till date. I have on my own gone and met the Minister of Human Rights, made reports on this, tried to tell them that despite the fact that we do have the Hague Convention on Child Abduction for such cases, one of the faults that I feel is one of the setbacks is ke wo kehte hain ke within 1 year aapko ye case file karna hai. Ab mere paas ek aurat hai jisse 10 saal se apne bacche nahi dekhe, ek 1.5 years old hai aur ek 4.5 tha jab wo abduct hua tha Pakistan se. The number of marriages between Pakistan and in England since the 1960s is enormous, and the number of cases that I'm getting now is absolutely, I mean, I don't know, I don't have anyone to look for to look up to on this.
I mean, iska Hasibula baithe piche Lahore High Court ki website pe I spoke on this issue, child abduction ke upar mera lecture YouTube mein hai, wo dekhna. I'll explain you. Issue is Pakistan only acceded to it, did, because it did not sign the treaty. Pakistan when acceded to is kind of only December 2017. We are in the form of our, because jab tak section 5 of the West Pakistan Family Court Act ko nahi amend karenge, jab tak hum baki kanoon ko nahi amend karenge, wo protection nahi milti. But under that convention, the listed countries are listed there, which when you ratify a convention automatically mirror concept aa jata hai. So England ke alawa with anywhere in the world we will be protected, don't worry about that. Abhi Pakistan kaam kar hi isko